Blackstone Audio presents Mars, Our Future on the Red Planet, by Leonard David. Foreword by Ron Howard. This book is read by Andrew Reilly. Foreword. As a boy, I was excited by the pioneer experience. Old movies like How the West Was Won sparked my imagination, as did stories of the European explorers who embarked on long and perilous ocean journeys in search of undiscovered lands. Then, when I was 15 years old, we landed Apollo 11 on the moon. Along with hundreds of millions of other viewers, I watched with held breath as Neil and Buzz became the first humans to set foot on the lunar surface. I was deeply moved by the seeming impossibility of what we had just accomplished. During that broadcast, Mission Control relayed a phone call from President Nixon to the astronauts. He said to them, "Because of what you have done, the heavens have become a part of man's world." A new frontier had opened. Just 26 years after that, I was making the film Apollo 13. I was thrilled at the chance to tell the personal stories of these brave explorers of the modern era who had risked their lives in the name of human potential. I had the remarkable experience of interviewing most of those early astronauts and many others who were involved in the space program. And every conversation pointed to one conclusion. We've come this far. We have to keep going. Buzz Aldrin was adamant when he told me that the next dream to work toward was putting humans on Mars. In every generation, there are new frontiers, new places and ideas that we must discover, explore, and understand. That's curiosity, the force that drives us all and makes us human. We wonder, we ask questions, and in answering them, we learn and evolve. We've been asking questions about sending humans to Mars for a long time. Science fiction writers have been writing about it for over a century. It was just a matter of waiting for the moment when the technology could keep pace with our imaginations. Visionaries like Elon Musk are saying that moment is now, which is why now is the perfect time to tell this story. When the Mars Series project came to Brian Grazer and me, we were immediately excited by the vitality of the subject matter and the creative possibilities that the series offered. This is exactly the kind of storytelling challenge we've faced before and are always looking for. Stories about the grandeur of the human spirit, told through the lens of the human hearts and minds that make it happen. As the idea for the series was being developed, I began to think about Mars in ways that I never had before. The series would not just be about a mission to Mars, which had been addressed in movies and documentaries to some extent. It would take an even larger, longer, and more epic view into the actual colonization. And as I began to learn the staggering amount of research that had already been done into the viability of humans living on Mars, I was hooked. I had a new pioneer story to tell. As the creative process and the team started coming together, we settled on a unique and original storytelling perspective. We would tell the story of colonizing Mars looking back from the future, with the premise that we've already gone to Mars and this is what it took to get us there. To accomplish this, we created the series as a hybrid of documentary and scripted narrative, with our documentary footage serving as the past tense of the fictional future. It was an exciting challenge to combine these two genres in a new way that would transport audiences and give them a visceral and realistic sense of what it might be like to travel to and colonize Mars. Every great mission requires a great team, and this project is no exception. I am grateful for all the partnerships that helped bring this to life. Brian Grazer and everyone at Imagine Entertainment, Radical Media, which is always masterful in executing its productions, and National Geographic, which has always been so dedicated to helping us all better understand the world we live in and worlds beyond. I am also very appreciative.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.